Hello, this is David Diga Hernandez, and you're watching Spirit Church here on the Encounter TV Network. I'm continuing now my teaching on the gifts of the Holy Spirit by exploring the power gifts. But first, Stephen Moctezuma is here with me. He's going to lead you in some very anointed worship, and then we're getting right into this lesson. Let's worship now.
All is for you.
So I want to begin this lesson by going to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and this is going to be our main text here. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, let's start at verse number 7. A spiritual gift is given to each of us so we can help each other. Remember, gifts are given for service, not for status. To one person, the Spirit gives the ability to give wise advice. To another, the same Spirit gives a message of special knowledge. The same Spirit gives great faith to another, and to someone else, the one Spirit gives the gift of healing. He gives one person the power to perform miracles, and another the ability to prophesy. He gives someone else the ability to discern whether a message is from the Spirit of God or from another spirit, still another person is given the ability to speak in unknown languages or tongues, while another is given the ability to interpret what is being said. Verse 11, it is the one and only Spirit who distributes all these gifts. He alone decides which gift each person should have. So I want to explore the power gifts. Now, of course, I also talked about the leadership gifts and the service gifts, but here I want to focus in now on the power gifts. Notice that the Bible in this context tells us in 1 Corinthians 12 that a spiritual gift is given to each one of us, and then it goes on to list 9 power gifts. This means that every believer has at least one of the 9 power gifts. So as I go through these, listen, because the Holy Spirit may be revealing a spiritual gift to you. The first gift I want to look at is the gift of discernment. It's important to remember that the gift of discernment is not the gift of criticism or cynicism. You mustn't mistake your own skepticism. You mustn't mistake your own cynicism as the gift of discernment. Just because you're suspicious of everybody doesn't mean you have the gift of discernment. The gift of discernment was given to the body of Christ as a protective measure. The one with the gift of discernment can tell whether someone is coming with the Spirit of God, with a demonic spirit, or with the spirit of the world. And here, the word spirit doesn't necessarily mean the entity like a spirit. This is more in what name do they come in, or in what attitude, in what spirit do they come. So when someone hears a message, they can discern that that message is from God or is not from God. This is a powerful gift because, as I said, it's a protective gift. It's to protect, not to criticize. Some people call themselves discerners when, in fact, they're just critics. The gift of discernment is a very powerful gift, and we must make sure that if our gift is discernment, that we're not allowing our flesh to take the place of the Spirit. Discern truly by the Holy Spirit and not your own opinions. Then I want to look at the gift of faith. Now, here this is interesting because 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7 tells us very clearly that each person is given a spiritual gift to benefit the other. This leads me to believe that the gift of faith cannot possibly be my own faith, and this gift of faith should not be confused with saving faith or the faith that is needed to receive salvation or the measure of faith. This is the gift of faith. The gift of faith, I believe, according to the Scripture, is the ability to stir faith in another. You see, if the gift of faith is simply my ability to have faith, then I haven't really done something for someone else. So the gift of faith is the ability to supernaturally heighten the faith in others. This is a very powerful gift because when this gift is present, people are more likely to believe for miracles, for healing, for the promises of God. This is a gift that should be used to help encourage one another. Then there's the gift of healing. Now, this is different than the act of praying for the sick, as we see in Mark chapter 16. And it's also somewhat similar to the gift of prophecy in that some people confuse the gift for the function or even for the office. Remember, the prophet is someone who has authority and influence as a church leader. The gift of prophecy is something that is given to an individual to communicate the oracles of God. The ability to prophesy comes sometimes on certain believers. In other words, if you can hear God and repeat what you've heard, you're technically prophesying. So the gift of healing is similar to prophecy in that there is the gift of healing, that grace to see the healing miracle, and then there is also the ability to pray for the sick, which belongs to all believers. Anyone who believes can lay hands on the sick and see them recover, but this gift of healing, because it's listed in the context of 1 Corinthians 12, and all of the other gifts are meant to be used for the benefit of the body of Christ in somewhat of a public setting, this leads me to believe that this gift of healing is a grace to see the greater miracles and to see the healing more often than would someone who doesn't have the gift of healing. Also, this is a special focus of ministry, a ministry area focus to where they have a healing ministry. So this person's gift leads them to focus on healing. So it's different from the function in that regard. Then there's the word of knowledge. The word of knowledge is simply the supernatural receiving of information. Knowledge is information. And I might be able to come by information through natural means. I can read something online. I can learn something in a conversation. I can read something in a book. That's a natural means of receiving knowledge. The word of knowledge, however, is the supernatural means of receiving that knowledge. In other words, it's knowledge that I have that I should not otherwise have. It's knowing things about people. An example of this is Jesus communicating with the woman at the well. He was able to give her her whole history, and she said, "I perceive you are a prophet." Therefore, the word of knowledge is, categorically speaking, a prophetic type of gift. But the word of knowledge, remember, is not the word of guessing or the gift of guessing. Some people say, "I have the word of knowledge," and they go and just try to guess things about people. They try to fish for information. No, no. When the Holy Spirit gives the gift of knowledge, it's information that they know. It's knowledge. It's that inner witness. It's that confident faith. They receive it from God, and they know that they know that they know that they've heard the voice of the Holy Spirit. So the word of knowledge is a spiritual gift that allows you to know someone's circumstance, or maybe sometimes even know their name, or know their past, or know what's in their heart. That's the word of knowledge. The word of wisdom, like unto the word of knowledge, is supernaturally received wisdom. So an example of this would be like Daniel. He had the wisdom of heaven in him. Joseph had the wisdom of heaven in him. It's the wisdom of God coming through you. Where others might face a difficult circumstance or a dilemma and not be able to find a way out, the one with the gift of wisdom can hear from God, receive that wisdom from heaven, and navigate that difficult circumstance. Then there's the gift of prophecy. Now, I spoke about prophecy just a moment ago, and prophecy, yes, is a spiritual gift. All believers can hear God, and all believers can repeat what they've heard from God. That is a basic form of prophecy. But the gift of prophecy is a special, specific, focused area of grace. The gift of prophecy is more, how shall I say, it's a more potent way of communicating. In other words, God more often than not will speak to the person with the gift of prophecy. So someone with the gift of prophecy is going to receive messages from God for other people more often than would a person who doesn't have the gift of prophecy. Again, these are greater measures of an ability of the Holy Spirit and a more sharp focus on these areas. The gift of miracles, like unto the gift of healing, like unto the gift of prophecy, is that heightened grace, that greater potency. It's an increased likelihood that they will see the miraculous. It's also, I believe, an increased desire, a hunger for the miraculous in them, because the spiritual gifts God has placed in us become our desires. When God places a gift of prophecy or a gift of healing or a gift of miracles in someone, usually that is preceded, or the function of that gift is preceded by a great desire to prophesy, or a great desire to lay hands on the sick, or a great desire to see the miraculous. But again, I must emphasize that these are areas of focus. These are areas of grace. These are more potent abilities than is the average function in the life of the everyday believer. So all believers can see miracles. All believers can pray for the sick. All believers can, to some degree, prophesy, but that doesn't mean that they necessarily have these potent, focused areas of grace for that spiritual gift. Then there's the gift of tongues. Now, I've taught in the past, and I still do teach, that there are three expressions of the gift of tongues. There's the personal tongue, which edifies the individual. There's the proof tongue, which becomes a sign to the unbeliever, where they hear another believer or they hear a believer speaking in a language that believer does not know. And then there is the prophetic tongue, which you see regulated and talked about in 1 Corinthians 14. Here in 1 Corinthians 12, this is that prophetic tongue. This is where someone will stand, usually in the middle of a church assembly, and begin to speak in tongues. Now, the collective attention of that assembled body of believers will then focus on that person praying in tongues. They're sharing a message from God. That tongue is then interpreted by someone with the gift of tongues interpretation, which is also in the same verse, which is the ninth gift here. So the gift of tongues in this context is that prophetic expression, where in the midst of believers, whether it be a small Bible study setting or a church setting, that individual begins to pray in tongues. It commands the collective attention of the group of believers gathered, and then it is interpreted by someone with the gift of interpretation. Now, it's possible that the person who gives the tongue is also the one who is interpreting that tongue. I've seen that happen in church services many times. But regardless, this particular expression of the gift of tongues needs to be interpreted, as I said, it demands the attention, the collective attention of the believers. And those are the nine power gifts of the Holy Spirit. Now, I want to pray. I want to pray that God would give you the boldness to step out in faith and to exercise the gifts that He has placed on your life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we would be inspired to step out in faith and exercise that which you have placed upon our lives. We thank you, Father, for these gifts. We celebrate these gifts in the church, Lord. Help us to recognize and to honor these gifts and to appreciate these gifts and to allow these gifts to flow in those around us and in us. We thank you, Jesus, for your wonderful gifts given to us by the precious Holy Spirit. I want you to say it because you believe it. Say, amen. Well, that is it for the lesson. I want to welcome now the new members of Spirit Church. There you are up on the screen. We love you. We are praying for you. I always say that because I always mean it. If you'd like information on how you can join the Spirit family, go to davidhernandezministries.com/spiritchurch. Sign up for our online church. And now to your comments. These comments come from the Moment of Truth video titled, No More Excuses. This one will challenge you. Make sure you go and watch it. And while you are looking for that video, make sure you're also connecting with us on all the social media platforms. And when you subscribe to us on YouTube, be sure to click that notification bell so that you can receive the notifications when we release new content. So I'm going to read these comments from the video, No More Excuses. Don't forget, leave your comment and I may read yours in the future. The first commenter writes, Brother David, you give such good teachings. God bless you. Living for Heaven says, life-changing message from heaven. God bless you, DHM team. Belinda Fernandez writes, thank you, Lord, for your glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, man of God. So Belinda was blessed by what the Holy Spirit spoke. Emily Larimore writes, this truly was a God-given message. God bless you, brother. And finally, Above the Clouds Vlogs writes, hallelujah, praise God. I love the fire of the Holy Spirit in you, brother. God bless you and your family. Well, I want to invite you to be a part of what God is doing in this ministry. I know there's someone watching me right now, and you want to help. Your heart is to help. Your heart is for the gospel. Your heart is for souls. And you believe that the gospel needs to be preached. You believe that more people need to hear the word of God. You believe in healing. You believe in deliverance. You believe in the power of the Holy Spirit. So I want to welcome you to be a part of what we're doing as a ministry. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, the Bible says, seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and He will give you everything you need. That's my encouragement to you right now. Even in chaotic times, even in uncertain times, we can be sure of the promises of God. So I want to challenge you to take a step of faith and become a monthly supporter of this ministry or give a one-time donation. Help us continue to create the media, to continue to do live streams, to continue to host the Holy Spirit School online, which is a free Bible training program, to continue to do events all around the world. It's all done through donor support. And I know that as you step out in faith and as you put the kingdom of God first, God will meet your need. So I challenge you, whether you're doing well or whether you're in a challenging time, all of us should want to be a part of what God is doing in the earth. So help us continue as a ministry. Help us continue to go and grow. Put the kingdom of God first now. Let the Holy Spirit speak to your heart. Give a one-time gift into this ministry right now or become a monthly supporter. Go to davidhernandezministries.com/donate to give a one-time gift, or go to davidhernandezministries.com/partner to become a monthly supporter. Go and check out, by the way, davidhernandezministries.com/partner. If you're considering monthly partnership, there is a list of all of the benefits that you receive by being a monthly partner. One of those benefits is access to our monthly Zoom call that's exclusive for our monthly partners. But whatever you do, do it today. Do it for Jesus. Do it for souls. Do it for the sake of the kingdom. You believe the gospel should be preached. You believe in the message we declare. You believe in the power of the Holy Spirit. So join with us. Be a part of what we're doing. Give a one-time gift or become a monthly supporter today. Again, one more time. One-time gifts, davidhernandezministries.com/donate. Or you can sign up to become a monthly supporter by going to davidhernandezministries.com/partner. Well, that is it for this edition of Spirit Church here on the Encounter TV Network. Until next time, remember, nothing is impossible with God. Thank you for watching Encounter TV. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. Also, help us spread the gospel of Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit. Make a one-time donation or become a monthly supporter by clicking on the donate link now.